Harry, may I come in?
In what, sir?
Is it okay if I enter your office?
Yep.
Hello, Harry.
Hello, Mr. Sir?
I have to say, I'm extremely disappointed in your conduct yesterday afternoon.
I totally understand. I apologize from the bottom of my fart. Heart. I meant heart.
Harry, it doesn't matter what you say now. If it were up to me, you wouldn't just be out of consideration for a promotion. You'd be fired unceremoniously.
I'll start packing my desk.
Just a minute.
Yeah?
I said if it were up to me, you'd be fired.
Yeah, and I said I'd start packing my desk? I'm so confused.
It's not.
What's not what?
Jesus, Harry. What I mean is, it's not my decision whether you get fired or promoted.
Oh, so you were just trying to scare me.
No, you're just an idiot. You didn't understand what I said.
Okay, I guess that's better.
I guess. Anyway, what I'm trying to tell you is that ultimately, it doesn't matter what I think. Your fate here at Satisfactory Travel is really in the hands of our CEO.
You mean Mr. Neeplebaus?
Yes, Harry. For reasons I do not pretend to understand, he's convinced that you're actually a competent employee.
Wow.
And he's also convinced that he really knows how to prick a wiener.
Excuse me?
I said he's convinced that he really knows how to pick a winner.
Oh, got it. Sorry.
And as a matter of fact, he flew in a day early for Friday's board meeting, just to have a chance to talk with you. He's actually in my office right now, waiting to speak with you.
That's weird and intimidating.
Well, that may be, Harry. But if I were you, I wouldn't waste this opportunity. You definitely don't deserve it.
Excellent point, sir. I'll go and talk to the man. So you say he's in your office?
He is. I'll escort you down the hall.
Thanks.
Harry, not that I particularly want this meeting to go well for you, but my advice would be to avoid saying anything stupid around Mr. Neeplebaus.
You know, that hadn't occurred to me, sir. Thank you.
Sure. And, well, good luck, I guess.
Thanks.
Yes?
Mr. Neeplebaus?
Come in, Harry. And close the door. Have a seat.
So you, wanted to see me, sir?
Indeed. Harry, you and I have never met in person before, but it might surprise you to know that I've been following your work rather closely for some time now.
Really? Why's that, sir?
Because I know how to prick a wiener.
Well, I've actually heard that about you, sir, but I'm still a little confused. What's this all about?
Let me try to explain.